Thanks for giving me a call. Appreciate it.
You bet.
Yeah? So what's going on in your life? Nothing new and exciting, right?
No, not at all.
Pretty cool
stuff.
Just a
fun trip on the horizon.
Yeah. You know, geez, it's been a couple years. I lost track of you a little bit, but, you know, bring me up to date. You had made the team, and then, you know, last year you even got a little game time, right?
Yeah, I did. Got in the Penn State game and the Florida A&M game last year. I haven't gotten in this year, but it's still been a blast, obviously.
Yeah. I mean, what's it like being in the championship?
Well, it was an unreal feeling just as the clock winded down at the Sugar Bowl and knowing we were going to go to Dallas. It was just an awesome feeling. Really grateful that we had the playoff system so that we got a chance to do it, and can't wait for Monday night.
Yeah. For you personally, I mean, did you have other – I mean, like, I think, you know, I know that because of your family background, you kind of had that idea of going there to walk on, but did you have other football options that you could have done?
Yeah, I mean, there was obviously, like, UNH and UMaine that I could have pursued, or mostly it was the D3 NESCAC schools like Colby and Bates, but I don't regret my decision at all. This is definitely what I wanted to do.
At what age did you kind of have this idea that you wanted to give it a shot?
Well, I've been a Buckeye fan my whole life, so obviously playing in the Horseshoe and all that has been my dream forever. I didn't really think it was going to be a viable option until late in my senior year, but I just decided to go for it.
Yeah. I guess what do you consider your role now? How are you valuable right now to the team?
Mostly what I do is impersonate other teams' receivers all week, you know, running whatever plays they're going to run that our scout team runs, and helping out on scout special teams as well, just doing whatever I can at practice to get the team ready.
Yeah. And how do you enjoy that, I guess?
It's been a lot of fun. You know, I've met a ton of great friends, and just being a part of this whole experience, even though I haven't gotten to play, it's still been rewarding, and really, really appreciate the opportunity.
That is awesome. And your parents got some pretty good swag, I guess.
Oh, yeah, they love it. They get parents get tickets to all the games, flown out there, so it'll be a fun time.
Yeah. I guess when you you know, the experience you've had doing so much scout work, does that make you have any interest in coaching? Had you ever wanted to coach? I don't know. I just, you know, looking at the game from that perspective, I wonder if that ever makes you think that.
It's definitely interesting, but to be honest with you, just seeing the hours and the amount of time that the coaches have to put in, I don't know if that interests me right now, but yeah. It's incredible what they go through, and I don't know if I want to do it yet, but yeah.
Down the road,
it'll be an interesting opportunity.
Yeah, no, that's cool. I mean, I imagine that the amount of football you've learned there, I mean, can you even put it into words?
Oh, not at all. I mean, you're just always constantly meeting and watching film and learning about different defenses and different offenses and everything. It's interesting.
Is it exciting this week? Because it sounds like you're practicing there for a while and then you leave on Friday.
Yeah, we've been practicing all week at Ohio State, and then we'll practice Friday morning and then head out. So most of the practice will be here, and then it'll just be game preparation, the final preparations down there.
Awesome. I guess, you know, could you have even imagined that when you started this whole thing that you know, be a win away from winning a national championship?
I guess when I first came here, it was kind of a mess going on with the whole tattoo scandal, and we didn't have a great year my freshman year. But you know, the group of seniors I've been with, you saw the talent, and they kept bringing in more talent. So definitely thought it was a realistic possibility. I guess when our two quarterbacks went down, there was a little bit of, well, maybe not, but it's next man up, and Cardell's been awesome. So
that's incredible. How far down are you on the depth chart at quarterback, Peter?
Well, I'm not on the one at quarterback. I play receiver.
In the 20s, in the 30s?
I'd like to think maybe the teens.
Okay, all right. Nice. I forgot. There are a lot of fat guys, so a lot of linemen that probably you definitely step in front of. What's it been like for your family, your parents, and I forget, is it your father's parents that were Ohio State grads?
Yeah, but both my parents are from Ohio, so they're both big Buckeye fans. They really enjoyed the experience down in New Orleans and being able to be here for senior day down on the field against Michigan. I know they really loved those two opportunities.
Yeah, I was talking to to a producer here, Joe, who thought he saw you after the game on the field. Do you know if you were caught in the telecast? Has anyone said anything to you about that?
Yeah, I mean, I get people take, like, screenshots and pause the TV, and so I get sent those sometimes. So I have a good feeling of when I get on it. But
that's funny. You know, I'm going to try and get your parents on TV. How do you think that's going to go?
My mom will probably love that.
Good to hear. How about your dad?
I don't know about him. He's a little more shy, but he'll
right.
probably go for it.
I think I sold her on bringing in the gold pants, too.
Yeah, I bet you did. She's proud of those.
What's the story with those?
Francis Schmidt back in the 1930s, I think. Like, Michigan was having a success in the rivalry, and he said a speech about they put their pants on one leg at a time just like us, and Ohio State kind of went on a run, and they started awarding a pair of gold pants for every year that you beat Michigan.
And everyone gets one, or?
Yeah, everyone on the team gets a pair if you win.
Oh, that's cool. Awesome. Have you, over your football time, have you been able to keep in touch with any of your old football teammates or coaches or anything like that, you know, since you've been out there?
Oh, yeah, all my senior buddies, Evan Gendrasco, yeah. Zach Dulac, Matt Place and all them, and then Coach Will Scram. Every time I'm back, I always catch up with them, and I always keep in touch.
That's cool. That's awesome. And then, so what's the battle like to give out the tickets? It sounds like you got four for this one or six?
I get six for the bowl games. You know, it's mostly family and friends, and, you know, whoever asks first usually gets them.
Nice. Awesome. Peter, this is incredible, man. Thank you very much for giving me a call.
Oh, you bet.
Put a little story on Monday, and, you know, good luck. You know, I think you've made some Buckeye fans here, which is pretty cool. So.
Awesome. Well, go Bucks.